Hello friends, welcome to my channel. I'm S. Ravi Kumar, a certified solution architect and IT career coach. So today I'm back with another interview question. What is the difference between .NET framework, .NET core framework and .NET standard? So want to know? Let's get started. Since the time .NET Core came into market, this question is asked in many interviews that what is the difference between .NET Framework, .NET Core and .NET Standard. So let me explain this to you with the help of a PPT. So let's start with .NET Framework. As you can see, the definition of .NET Framework, which is written on the screen, .NET Framework is a software framework developed by Microsoft used for creating Windows-based desktop and web application. It has been there since last 20 years and many enterprises are running on this this framework or the applications developed using this framework. And as you can see, I have highlighted the text Windows-based, which means that the applications which are developed using .NET framework are primarily Windows-based, which means they run on Windows operating system. So if you have created a website using .NET framework, it will run only on Windows. Okay, so whether it is Windows Server or Windows Desktop or anywhere, if you create a desktop application using .NET framework, it will run on Windows. If you create a web application, you will need Windows Server to host it and to expose it to the internet. Okay, so its .NET framework is primarily based on Windows based. It was started 20 years back and many languages target to .NET framework, whether it is ASP.NET, ASP.NET MVC, ASP.NET WebForms, WPF, Silverlight and your WinForms. So all these technologies are used for creating Windows based application using .NET framework. Now let's talk about .NET Core framework. As you can see from the definition given on the screen, .NET Core is a free and fully open source software framework for creating cross-platform web, desktop and cloud software. It is available under MIT and Apache 2 license, so anybody can use it. And it was released in 2016 and since then it is growing exponentially, which is a very true statement. Every month there are around 1 million developers who are joining with .NET Core and learning and creating applications using .NET Core. Like 1 million are, I think, 1 million new developers. So .NET Core is, as it's mentioned in the definition, it is used for creating it's open source framework, which is used for creating web, desktop and cloud softwares. Which can run on, it's a cross platform, so it can run on Windows, Mac as well as Linux systems. So in Linux it supports, I think, Ubuntu, Debian and all the other Linux distribution support, which you can get from the list from the Microsoft site. Okay, you can get the whole list from the Microsoft site. So as I said, .NET Core is basically a framework for developing cross-platform application. Another benefit is it's open source and free. So community is also supporting it. Community is also creating components for .NET Core, and it is being accepted in the community with open hands. So that is .NET Core for you. So now let's talk where to use which one. Okay. So when we talk about .NET Core, as .NET Core is cross-platform, so you can use .NET Core wherever you want to develop a cross-platform application. So let's say you are going to develop a new application using .NET Core. My suggestion would be to go, if you want to develop a new application using .NET technologies, my suggestion would be to go with .NET Core. If you have, if you want to create microservices, again, my suggestion would be to go with .NET Core. If you are planning to use Docker container, then again you can go with .NET Core. If you need a high performance and scalable system, again you will go with .NET Core, because .NET Core application is like a simple same code which is written in .NET framework and .NET Core. The .NET Core code is 40 times more faster than the .NET framework code because it's more modular and it's like more scalable, and it has been tuned. The compiler, .NET Core compiler, has been tuned to give more performance. if you need side by side .NET versions per application. So what do you mean by side by side execution? Like in .NET, it is not possible to do side by side execution. At a time on the server or on the machine, you can have only one .NET framework installed. So on Windows, you can either have at a time only one .NET framework running, which is either you can have 4.6, 4.7 or 4.8. So if you have to deploy, if you have one server where you are hosting a .NET application and that application is written in .NET 4.6, and now you are writing another application which is written on .NET 4.8. So you can't host that application, that 4.8 application on that server. Either you have to upgrade the previous application or you have to downgrade this new application. Whereas this is possible with .NET Core. So if you have like .NET Core 2.0 on your server, you can install .NET Core 3.0 on the server and then you can run the application which is targeting to .NET Core 3.0 on the same server. So it's like it supports that parallel execution, which is not supported is in .NET framework. Okay, so now let's talk about where to use .NET framework. So if you are working on a maintenance project or a legacy application which is already developed in .NET framework, so the recommendation is to extend that application if you can't migrate it. So if you can migrate it, if it is a large application and you can't migrate it, so you can extend it with .NET framework. Or if your application use any third party .NET library or NuGet packages which are not yet ported to .NET Core, or the version for that in .NET Core it's not available, so in that scenario you can develop your application in .NET framework. But this happens very rarely, frankly speaking, but it can happen with old device drivers or something, so you have to check what you are developing. Or your app uses .NET technologies that are not available on .NET Core. So for example, if you have WCF services, so WCF services are not available in .NET Core. So if you are extending WCF services, then you have to use .NET framework only. If you are using ASP.NET Web Forms application, or if you are extending ASP.NET Web Forms application, then again you have to use .NET framework, not the .NET Core. So this is where you have to use .NET framework instead of .NET Core. These differences I have taken from Microsoft document site, the link to which is given in the PPT, and I'll give it in the description of the video also. So if you want to read more in detail about these differences, you can go to this link and read yourself. Now let's talk about .NET standard. As you can read from the definition given on the PPT, .NET standard is a specification for implementing the BCL or base class library on each .NET or .NET Core supported platforms. It contains a set of APIs that all .NET platforms must implement, and it's primarily used for writing cross-platform libraries and shared Xamarin or Xamarin Form code. So this definition is pretty explanatory that .NET standard is not a framework, it's a specification. Like when we talk about interfaces and classes, so interfaces are basically specification or blueprint which any class can implement as per their requirement. Similarly, .NET standard is a specification, and whatever features are written in .NET standard, specifications, all the platforms have agreed that these features will be implemented in all the platforms, all the versions of .NET framework. So whether it is .NET framework, regular .NET framework, or .NET Core, whatever feature is written in .NET standard, it is available in the .NET framework, whether .NET framework or .NET Core, or whether it is UWP or Xamarin or anything. So if you see, if you want to see what all features are available in .NET frameworks, you can see this table given on the screen, where you can see the .NET standard version and the .NET framework, which framework support which version of .NET standard. So as I said, .NET standard is a specification. So in this video, we understood the differences between .NET framework, .NET Core, and .NET standard with the help of PPT. So as you can see, .NET framework and .NET core framework, both of these are framework, whereas .NET standard is a specification for developing application targeting to these frameworks. I hope you like this video. If you want to watch more such videos, do subscribe to my channel. And if you like this video, please hit that like button also. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.